Praise the Lord, everybody. Brother Rod coming at you with some real talk. Just wanted to share a brief story with you, something that may help someone else that may find himself in a very similar situation. This middle-aged or older gentleman came into my repair facility one day. And he asked one question about his car, and we spent the next hour talking about his life and his wife. I mean, and his brother. The whole time he talked, he just boo-hooing, tears running down his eyes. And I got to tell you, you know a brother's hurt when he can come standing for another brother that he don't know, has no relationship with, and then cry for an hour. So this brother was in pain. And this brother was telling me that he had been with his wife for 27 years. He said he came home one day, and he noticed that half the furniture looked to be missing. And then he asked her what was going on. She said, "Well, I just stuck around to let you know that I'm gone." She said, "I'm moving on. I met somebody else. And it's been nice, but I'm out of here." He said they had three kids. Two were grown. One was about the age of 18, getting ready to move on, you know, in his life. And he said he was devastated and crushed. He said he had, according to him, he had been everything to his woman. Because, you know, it's two sides to every story. But according to him, he had been everything to this woman. He said that every car that she owned for the last 27 years, he paid for. He said the house he paid for, the lights, the gas, the water he paid for. He said every time her tank in her car looked like it was getting close to E, he took it to the gas station. He filled it up with fuel. He said she didn't want for nothing, and he didn't want her to want for nothing. He was always taught, according to him, that you treat your woman like a queen that she is, and you don't allow her to be wanting or looking or needing anything from anybody else. He said they didn't have any outside forces coming in between them. He said to him, everything was perfect. That's why it was so devastating to him when she said she was gone. And when she left, he said it was almost as if she was my legs. He said I couldn't walk. I couldn't think. He said I spent the next 2.5 weeks in the bed just crying. He said I didn't go to work. I didn't call in to work. He said I just couldn't even focus on anything else but how he felt and the loss he felt from her leaving. And he said he got up one morning to go to the bathroom. He got about halfway to the bathroom and he collapsed on the floor. He's having a heart attack. He said he had to be rushed to the hospital. He opened up his shirt and he showed me the scar when he had open heart surgery on him. He said, "I've been out the hospital for a week and a half." He said, "But my tears still haven't stopped." And he said, "I don't know what to do from here." So I asked him, I said, "Well, do you have a relationship with the Heavenly Father?" He said, "Well, no." He said, "My parents never really had a relationship. They never really introduced me to church. So, I mean, I was never interested." He said, "But I was always told to love your wife above all and anything else." I said, "Well, you know, it sounds like you did a good job with loving your wife." I said, "But the problem was you built your house and it didn't have a foundation beneath it. Therefore, the first opportunity that the devil could step in and take what was yours, he did." And the reason I say that, because I'm sure your wife didn't have a relationship with him neither, right? She said, "No, he didn't. We just didn't do that kind of thing." I said, "Well, everything that's done on this earth that you go through in your life always start with a foundation." I said, "Your house that you live in was built on a foundation. Your education had a foundation to it. Your job had to be started with a foundation. Everything is built off of a foundation. So you have to have a foundation with the Heavenly Father, because one thing about people will change with the wind. People will love you today and leave you tomorrow. People will say Hosanna to you today and say crucify him tomorrow. If they'll crucify the Most High God, then you are nobody. So you must have a relationship with the Heavenly Father first. And once you build that relationship with him, once you have that foundation with him, then comes your queen, then comes your kids, then comes your friends and everything else that fall in line underneath that. I said, "But without that foundation, you are at risk of crashing and burning in your life." Because see, now don't be mistaken, that's what I told him, to think that just because you had that foundation in Christ, that your wife wouldn't have walked out of 27 years. Because people change. Their feelings change. But what makes it different when you have that foundation in Christ, that's when they leave, they die, they change their mind, they love you today, hate you tomorrow. You don't die with them. You know, you have trust in the Lord that whatever decision has had to be made, well, no matter how painful it is, you're going to live through it and move on from it. And anything that the Lord allows to happen in your life is room for you to do better and be better at whatever the trial or the situation was. So if she's moved on, then God has something better for you. I said, but you.